And welcome back again to the next episode. I just want to level up and I got ambushed by three bandits who very kindly are letting me loot their dead bodies. Yay! In the last video I went over the fact about basically my character concept. What I'm changing and what I will be using more, which is basically illusion, since I'm a Argonian. Anything interesting in here? Oh, there is. I got fined by a Stormcloak, which is kind of interesting because Stormcloaks have no jurisdiction here. Whiterun should be Empire. So the Stormcloaks just got a little bit more annoying for me at the very least. Oh yeah, I also want level up, so let's have a look at that. I got health, stamina and magicka's lagging behind. I'm gonna very slightly add little bits of magicka to somewhat keep up my magic abilities. And I'll start talking about the abilities that I'm planning on. First one I'm wondering, and I hope you guys can help me with that, is smithing. Should I take smithing or not? I can choose two paths in smithing, as probably you guys all know. I can go for the heavy armor smithing, which is what most people say. Even if you're a light armor wearing person, go for the heavy side, just so you can make yourself the Daedric weapons. The problem is, it to me feels very power game-ish. Why do I want to go and spend so much time doing heavy armor smithing when I'm just a rogue? It just doesn't feel right on a playing type skill that I'd like to have in my games. It feels as if I'm power gaming. Now if I go to the light side, light armor side, the first tier, Elven Smithing, is absolutely worthless whatsoever. If I want Elven armor, I can just go out, find me a Thalmor, hit him on the head, and voila, I've got a full set of Elven armor, I think. So that's a little bit of a problem. Not quite sure what to do about this. Any feedback whatsoever, very welcome. Oh, I forgot also, apparently you can get special armor sets from the Dark Brotherhood and the Thieves Guild, from what I heard from people. So, I'm not sure about smithing, could be something, couldn't be something. We'll see. Then we have one-handed. I'm planning to go up in the one-handed tree, up to at the very least. Armsman. That's it. The rest are uninteresting to me. Maybe Jewel Flurry, not sure. But Armsman is a definite damage upgrade for me. Then there's Archery. Archery thus far has been very, very good. I'm liking Archery. It's working perfectly for me. Fits the character concept. Of course, Light Armor. I'm gonna go for both sides, fill up everything up, because it just is a great tree. Sneak. I'm not even going into sneak. I'm taking sneak. Lockpicking. I'm not too hot about lockpicking because I'm already doing extremely well without all the perks. One of the only perks that are somewhat interesting are Golden Touch and Treasure Hunt here, over here. If I can. There we go. 50% greater chance of finding special treasure. This can be all sorts of treasure, up to magical equipment to even magical dragon scale armor and items like that. It's interesting, something to consider later on perhaps. Pickpocket, it's another thing I'm kind of wondering about. Is it worth it or not? I definitely like this talent, extra pockets. Gives me 100 extra carrying capacity, which means more loot to haul. It's that simple. Speech is another one that's kind of, I don't know, is it interesting, is it not? More so it's the fence, can barter stolen goods. An investor, in basically merchant that you invest in. You give them like money and then you get money back from them, I assume. So that speech alchemy. Alchemy is on my list to do because I still have this firm belief that alchemy will be giving me the ability to do better. It will give me the edge because I'm thinking that illusion, even though I'm taking it, which I'll be talking in a sec, illusion won't work on dragons. Poisons, however, hopefully will. Now we come to the magical part. Illusion. I will be taking illusion on my Chada. Why? As you've seen already, by the times that I actually used it, Frenzy is amazing. It gives the chance for me to break up large packs of people into hysterical mass of people fighting amongst each other. And when there's only one or two left, I can just go up ahead and backstab them in peace and quiet. I'm liking it. It has muffle, invisibility, and fear and calm. And I'm kind of expecting calm to work like it always has. You calm someone and you can still backstab them. That'd be very nice. Conjuration. I've been thinking about conjuration and more so the conjuration weapons. Because you can like soul steal and the best conjuration bow and dagger are apparently of Daedric type damage wise quality. So that is interesting, but still it's a large investment. I'm already taking considering going smithing, and I'm like, you know, if I take smithing, wouldn't it be easy to just invest those few points into the other line in smithing and take Daedric or something? Something to consider. Destruction. I'm taking destruction up to Rune Master because I still have this firm belief that I should be using traps as assassin, rogue type person type thingy. And that's basically it. I'm not interested in restoration whatsoever, only when the need is extremely high, like in my previous dragon fight. Alteration. It seems nice, but I don't know. It's not really tickling me at all. And lastly, enchanting. Do I go for enchanting or not? And I know that's a lot of questions for you guys, but I'm pretty sure you guys have played a lot further than I have and know a lot more things than I do. I've read a few posts on the forums and everyone is saying if you take smithing, alchemy and enchanting on one character, you become like super strong and overpowered. And kind of trying to avoid it a little bit, even though I continuously am getting my ass handed to myself. It's not something I'd like to do in my first game. Anyways, my point. I'm going to put my point, my first point, in, well, since I just leveled up, in illusions, so I can actually cast my illusion spells, like Fear, which I will be picking up, and Fury, which has been nice to me as well. And excuse me for clearing my throat, I seem to have caught a little bit of a cold, but I'll be okay. Heading to a little guard outpost here. Why is he coming towards me? Oh, no he isn't. Whoa! Damn! Oh, there's another one up there. Oh yeah, Chuck! Another thing I've been thinking about, and I've been, as you can tell, I've been thinking a lot about my character. Should I go and take the Warrior Stone?
Disrespect the law and you disrespect me.
For getting my one-handed up. I'm personally thinking, no, it'll go up eventually. It's not much use to that. Dead bandits here. I'm already carrying too much. Come on. I haven't even picked up this arrow here yet. See? Now I did. Whoa, he got shot in the head.
Some dragon or giant.
That's a nice shot.
Ready.
Yeah, I know. You'll be ready when a dragon comes, dude. Let's have a little looky what I can dump then. First shoes. I can definitely drop the first shoes. I don't want to drop anything else, because it's loot. I like loot. Weapons. wel. And I'm gonna go back to town to sell my loots. Yay, loots. I will be doing a trade skill vid sometime soon. I'm not sure if I already mentioned it. If I already did, my apologies. In the trade skill vid, I will be working on alchemy at the very least. If people basically say that other trade skilling will be good as well, then I'll be going over those. If not, it's just gonna be a trade skill vid featuring alchemy. The one thing that's kind of been scaring me a little bit with the trade skilling is I'm afraid that due to trade skilling, my level will rise too far. And basically what happens is the mobs in the world will go too high as well. Which means that skills such as my Fury, that I'm planning to use, will become useless and I'll need to start using the upgraded version. But to use the upgraded version, I need to have the next adept type level, so I can cast them without using so much mana. As you can tell, that's one of the concerns that's been on my head. Is it worth it or not? Maybe I should invest in some enchanting and like illusion cost reduction gear or enchant on that gear. I don't know. That's one of the main things that I love about this game. There is so many options that you can basically walk down and see if it works or not. Anyways, we were going to sell our loot. Yes, I know this. All running business seems kind of boring, so let's skip it. At least the last bit. Someone also said I should totally join the companions. My plan is to join every single faction that I can, like the main groups that run around here, such as the Mage's Guild, the Assassin's Guild, the Thieves' Guild, the Companions. Hopefully they don't have trouble with each other. If they do, I'll have to make choices. Hello, Lydia. How are you doing?
Long life to you, Thane.
And to you as well. She always makes me smile. Quick sleep. Five hours should be sufficient for a lizard, right? Was there anything in here that I wanted to sell as well? Yup. Yup. Steel helmet. Now it's heavy. 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 Swords, gauntlets, steel helmet. Fury helmet. Just grabbing everything and trying to sell it so I can move on with the new money I made and perhaps buy me some spells that I'm gonna be very, very much in need of. Wine. Yeah, I'm gonna keep it like that. And yes, I'm gonna be walking very, very slowly. Oh! See, I almost forgot something. Potion of Haggling. Already have it on. Items. Potions. I could have sworn that I have had a potion of haggling. I guess not. Okay, fine. Then I don't have a potion of haggling. I don't know if it was in the chest. Everybody would be screaming, "Oh my god, you just looked over it." And as you've guessed, that just was my timer. I'm gonna go and stop the episode here. Walk over to the smith, sell my items, and I'll start the episode there.